Welcome back. I've got a small unboxing to do today. Let's get rid of these things first. Make sure we got a little bit of room. It's related to this thing. Guesses of what it might be. I've been wanting one of these things for quite some time, and I'm not sure. Hey, look at that, made in China. The price on these things, I seen yesterday, anywhere up to $600. Of course, I wouldn't tell my wife how much that would be. So let's just have an idea. I'm not sure where to put it actually yet. So let's open it up. It's going to work out for me here. Ooh. I think it might. All right. It's a vice. Yahoo! Burn that later. So on the side of the box it says, and it's interesting, Princess Auto, destination Delta, BC. That's on the other side of the country. That's approximately 4,000 miles away from here. So somehow this here ended up probably in the back of a truck and dragged across the country. So it's big enough for what I want, and what I want it for is I can't hold anything on with this one. I'll just tip you down here. See this? That was never mounted in the right place to begin with, but that's okay. And the other one I got, it's not much good for anything. That was a freebie. So it's got replaceable jaw blades with a dual swivel locking lever, which is up to 4 inches. But it doesn't swivel. Oh well. It's gonna have to do. Place for it without it taking my whole bench up. Hmm. looks like a good spot right here. That'll do the trick. Next, I need not sure where we are. Here we are. Let me see here. Shorter. Don't need the super long ones, that's for sure. And I don't like throwing things out. Try that. And if they're too long, I just want it to suck into the it's got to go through. Okay, it's going to be longer than that. Is I don't know if I've got enough. I know the long ones aren't going to work. reason why I don't want to put the big long ones in there is when I reach underneath here, I don't want the tip of this freaking thing ripping my hand out or anybody else puts their hands under there. Now I can also drill it out and put a bolt in there. I don't think I want to do that either. Try these guys. Yeah, that should work. Okay. Vice, you could, it had a little lever on the side of it so you could rotate the base, but oh well, this will have to do. What I wanted is I couldn't afford it. It was one of those ones with the round. So that this whole head would swivel. But that's okay. This I'll use for the chainsaw. And whatever else I gotta put in here. Let's see how this goes. Thank you. Yeah. There we go. All right. All right, just starting to come through. That's the hole right there. Okay. It's on solid now. Okay. All Okay, let's test it out. Ooh. Good. Now, perfect. Okay, let's see. Now, I can use two hands. Perfect. This will be the sharpest this saw has ever been. When I went to print this auto, I forgot to bring the files, that other kit that I bought, and I'm going to go and get myself a vise for out in the woods, for on a stump that holds the saw. Find out where we started from here. All looks the same. start there, I guess. So this is left. Works good. Big improvement anyway. No bucking Billy Ray, but you're making a big difference, that's for sure. So before I use the new chain, I want to get a new bar. But I want to get as much out of this old chain as I can. Thank you. enough. Picking now. There we go. So, I missed the window of opportunity. I cannot burn right now. I couldn't burn yesterday, actually. So, I might go out and split some wood after. But right now, I'm going to wrap this video up. That's the new vise, and it works pretty good. Every once in a while, I need to hold on to something, and this other one, it doesn't do the trick anymore, so I might take that off. And I've got to remount this, because it should come up flush to the top. I don't know if you can see that or not. This is a wood vise, actually. And Nicholas, if you ever watch these videos, here's a bag of tools and stuff that you can have. And you can have this too. Throw that in there as well. There. All you gotta do to get these is show up. Alright. Looks good. Beating on something here. Good. And I need to go get make some soft jaws for it. There. And I don't think it did any damage to the chainsaw, no. So the next time I use the saw, I'll flip the bar over. And I'll keep doing that until the chain's no good. Then I'll throw the bar away and the chain away. Okay. If you got any ideas what to do with the old chain, I've got one to experiment with. And I was thinking about putting it on two wood handles so that I could use it like a handheld chainsaw. But anyway, that's it for now. Thanks for watching. And don't forget to subscribe and like it. And leave comments. I enjoy getting comments from you folks. Okay, goodbye.